What's up, guys? Today on What the Tech, we are talking about joules versus FPS.
What the Tech?
So, when you're talking joules in Airsoft, talking about the energy of the BB, and there's two basic levels of misunderstanding. The first is why the weight of the BB matters at all. They're all little BBs, they're all really light, so what's the difference? Why can't we just measure the velocity we're shooting at? Why does it matter if velocity is 350 FPS, why does it matter whether that's 350 FPS with .2s, with .3s, or whatever else you're shooting? So this is the first level of misunderstanding. We're gonna jump on this one first, and then we're gonna get into joule creep. So, the real problem here is that we're talking about such small things. When you're talking about BBs, they're really, really small. They're all the same shape, same size. And the weight difference isn't enough that we can detect it very easily just holding it in our hand. Let's scale this up and talk about something that we understand much more intuitively. For instance, balls. I have two balls here. They're both the same size, roughly. One is a baseball. The other is a plastic ball. Now, I'm pretty sure that all of you, if I gave you the option of being hit with this ball at 80 miles an hour, or this ball at 80 miles an hour, pick this one. Because we know intuitively the light ball is not going to hurt as much. The same way with an airsoft BB. Now, the difficulty is that we can't see the difference, right? But this difference is still there. And you can still measure the difference, and it makes a difference in how much it hurts. So that's really what we're talking about. The BBs are the same size, but they weigh different amounts. So if you throw them at the same speed, the heavier one's going to hurt more and do more damage. That's why this is a requirement. That's why we have velocity limits at a given BB weight. Now, some of you might be saying, but I don't actually care about the weight. It's actually that one ball is harder than the other. And that is a contributing factor, but keep in mind that the real issue here is that airsoft BBs are actually the same way. A 12 gram BB is going to be made out of a much softer plastic generally than say a 0.4 gram BB. So there is a difference there, but the main difference is still the weight. And that's the main thing that we have to worry about when we're talking about how much damage the BB is going to do. All right, so that's the basic misunderstanding in terms of energy or joules versus velocity. Now let's talk about joule creep. Joule creep is a little bit more complicated, but it mostly is complicated because, again, we don't think about it the right way. Now, joule creep is the phenomenon that the same gun, set up exactly the same way, will actually shoot harder, not in terms of the velocity, but in terms of the energy you're putting out, or the joules you're putting out, if you put in heavier BBs. Nothing else changes on the gun, right? The same spring or the same air pressure, same barrel, hop up, all that kind of stuff. But all you do is you swap BBs and all of a sudden it's hitting harder. Now this intuitively doesn't seem right to us because we think it's the same gun. How can it hit harder just because we changed the weight of the BB? It's a little difficult to get a really good visual on that, so instead of balls, we're going to talk about bats. So to demonstrate this point, we need to do some science. Thankfully, we have a brave volunteer here who is going to let me hit them with both bats and tell us which one hurts more. So, unfortunately, we have to report that the test was a failure. We selected an unqualified test subject, and after the completion of the test, they were unable to provide any data at all. But, good thing we found a new test subject. So for the actual experiment, we're going to be hitting potatoes. I will be swinging two bats, one that is a light plastic bat, one is a standard baseball bat. And we're going to see the dramatic difference that the weight of the bat has on the damage done to the potato. Keep in mind, that the same person is swinging both bats essentially as hard as I can. I don't suddenly become stronger by picking up a heavier bat, and yet it allows me to do much more damage to the same potato. So what's going on here? Obviously, by using a heavier bat, I can do a lot more damage. I can build up a lot more energy with the heavier bat. And the same thing is true with the airsoft gun. Even though the gun itself isn't stronger, the spring isn't any stronger, the air is running at the same pressure, by using a heavier projectile, we improve the efficiency of the energy transfer. That's a fancy way of saying that we basically allow the gun to build up more energy by giving it a heavier projectile. Now, how this happens in the airsoft gun in particular, the amount of energy that we can build up in the BB is a function of how hard we're pushing on it and how long we push for. This is just the same as if you put a bunch of weights on a cart and you started to try to get the cart going as fast as you could and build up as much energy as you could. The longer you push on the cart and the harder you push on the cart, together are going to build up more energy in the cart. It's the same with the BB. With a heavier BB, it's going to build more back pressure. In other words, it's going to provide more resistance to the air trying to push it. So the pressure is going to build up and provide a greater force on the BB. Also, because it's heavier, it's going to take longer to accelerate, so the heavy BB will actually stay in the barrel longer, meaning that the air can work on it for a longer period of time. This is actually true whether you're talking about AEGs or HPA systems or just about anything else. Now, why is it more pronounced with an HPA system? This is a little bit complicated, but it has to do with the fact that the HPA system can generally provide a continuous flow of air, so it can keep building up pressure as long as you want, whereas the AEG is firing a fixed volume of air, so it can only build up so much pressure behind the BB. So essentially, both systems do it, but the HPA system Joule creeps more efficiently. So if you're a field owner, a game organizer, or anybody responsible for ensuring the safety of an event, this means you need to do one of two things. First, you can chronograph each player with the BBs they're going to use. This will allow the chronograph to give you an output on the amount of energy that they are actually going to be shooting on the field. Now, there's a few serious problems with this. Obviously, the person could be lying about what weight BB they're using. We don't really have a good way to measure that on the field or at the chrono station. Second, they could change BBs afterwards. Again, there's so much you can do about it. So there's a number of problems with that. So your second option is what we recommend. How much effect you get from Joule Creep is a function of how much change in BB weight you have. So if you chrono your players with 0.2 gram BBs and they go out on the field with 0.4s, there can be a huge difference in the energy output of the system. So what we recommend is chrono with heavier BBs. You don't have to use the heaviest 0.4s or 0.43s, but if you chrono everyone with, say, 0.32s, the effect of the Joule Creep going from 0.32s to 0.4s, if they're playing with them on the field, is not going to be nearly as dramatic as if you chrono with 0.2s and then they're actually shooting 0.4s. Now to the players out there, it's your responsibility as the owner of the gun and the person pulling the trigger to ensure that you are playing safely and you're not endangering the people you're playing with. That means that even if your field doesn't require chronoing with heavyweight BBs, and just requires chronoing with 0.2s, this is very common, it's your responsibility to understand your own gun and make sure that you're shooting safely. So if their limit is 400 with 0.2s, but you're gonna be shooting 0.4s, then you need to check your gun ahead of time, make sure that you chrono at a point with 0.2s, such that you're still at a safe Joule rating when you switch to 0.4s. If you need help with how to do that, get in touch with us. We can provide lots of information. It makes the process very easy. And I'm sure the field owner will not mind if you borrow their chronograph before the game in order to make sure that you're playing safely and fairly. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope this video has shed a little light on this grand mystery of the Joule Creep. If you like this video and want more content like this, be sure to give us a subscribe here on YouTube. Give us a follow on Facebook and Instagram for more good content around not only our products, but everything having to do with Airsoft.